Hi guys, it's Kendra. So for today's video, I am going to be doing an empties video for you guys, and I have not done an empties video in years. It was a while ago. So I've been collecting quite a few products in this Whole Foods bag. It's kind of ridiculous, the amount of products that are in this bag. I saved them all for you guys so that I can go through these products to let you guys know what's worth repurchasing and what's not worth repurchasing. So I'm basically going through my trash. This is what an empties video is for those of you who don't know, who have not been watching YouTube videos since the archive days. If you're not one of those people, then this is what this video is about. If you love products, if you like recommendations, then you clicked on the right video because there's quite a few products in here. So I'm just gonna hop right into it. Okay, so the first product is a body lotion. This is from the brand Epicurean Discovery, and this is their Kukui Coconut After Bath Moisturizer. I don't know why they just don't say lotion. This is a body lotion and a kinda overpriced, no not kinda, it is overpriced lotion. But this is one of those products where you see it all the time and you're like, oh, I really want to try that. I'm not gonna lie, I saw Kim Kardashian using this. She talked about this lotion on her Insta story on Instagram, and she said how much she loves it and how amazing it is, and it is a really good lotion. It's one of those products that you buy and you try to wonder if it's really worth the price, but then you like, but it worked though. But Nivea also works though. So if you're not someone who likes to splurge on hygiene products, on body care, then you probably don't need this. But if you are a product junkie like myself and you like trying new body lotions and things like that, then I think you would love this. And if you like coconut products, you would love this. And this is the only lotion that I like for out of the shower at night. I typically use body lotions in the daytime because they're a little bit lighter, not as heavy. But this, I actually like this for nighttime because it's a little bit more moisturizing. Like, it's a lotion, but it feels like a little bit heavier than a normal lotion because a lot of lotions are very lightweight. At night, I typically like a body butter or a body oil, but this is really good. But this was like $35, so it's too much for lotion. Next, I have a hair product, and this is from the brand Caracare. This is their Clear Protein Styling Gel, and I have gone through quite a few of these. I would not be surprised if there is another one in here. This is one of my favorite gels. I discovered this last summer, and I was using this nonstop on my curls. This product is the product that I use in my one product curly hair routine. So if you guys have not seen that video, I did do that for you guys. I was just obsessed with my results, and I love how consistent this product is. That's one of my pet peeves when it comes to wearing my curly hair. Sometimes when I use something and I like it, my hair doesn't come out the same every time. But this product, I was obsessed. So I love this gel. It's just like a clear protein styling gel, like I said, and it dries very soft. So that's what I love about this. So that's why I use it by itself. They do have a leave-in conditioner, but it's like a lotion. I have not tried that yet with this product, but I will try that in a few months with the gel to see how I like it. But alone is amazing by itself. So love this product. And of course, I've already repurchased this gel, so there's your answer. Another hair product I have here is the Kinky Curly Not Today Natural Leave-In Detangler. This is a OG product of mine. This product saved my hair back in those days when it was problematic and not manageable at all. So I love this product. It's an amazing detangler. It is on the pricier side. Kinky Curly is one of those brands where it's just like, really? Y'all gonna go down a little bit on your prices, but it's so worth it. And this product is really good for the really stubborn tangles that are really hard to get out of your hair. So if you have really tangly, annoying, stubborn hair, then you would love this. Overall, it is a really good leave-in, and I've seen that it works on a lot of different hair types. So I love this product, and you guys should definitely try it if you have not. And along with that, I always use the Kinky Curly Original Curling Custard. This product is one of my favorite gels. I'm not gonna lie, since I've experienced other gels since using this, I do like other gels a little bit more than this, but this is still a really good product. It has amazing slip, like it's bomb. So this is like the perfect summer curly hair routine, these two products to me. And I love the smell of this. It's so good. It's really sweet. Highly recommend it. Again, this is an OG brand, so it's been around for years. And for a lot of people, I actually see that they either love this product or they hate this product. There's usually no in between. So I love it. Highly recommend it if you haven't tried it. If you want super defined curls, it gets a little bit softer and more like fluffy as the days go by, but like first and second day hair, it is kind of like extra defined. So if you don't like that look, then you won't like this, or you can just use less product. Okay, a little bit of a break from the hair products. I have a skincare product here that I finished. This is from the brand Elemis. This is their Pro Collagen Cleansing Balm. This product is so, so good. This is actually the first balm type product that I've tried to remove my makeup. I typically use a cleansing oil, not a balm, but I saw this in Ulta and I've heard good things about this product and I decided to try it and it's amazing and I would 1000% repurchase this. So next time I'm in Ulta, I'm gonna get another one because it was so, so good. I cannot stand makeup wipes, like period, to remove my makeup with because they take way too long. I'm like tugging and pulling on my face and it's just a complete waste of time because even after you use like 3 or 4 wipes, there's still a lot of makeup still on your face. And products like this literally get the job done so much faster and it's just better for your skin. So it's less damaging. You're not tugging and pulling on your skin because gravity will do that for us eventually anyway. So a cleansing balm product is what you need in your life because who wants wrinkles? It has a very nice spa smell, kind of minty, but like a clean, like minty smell. I really love this product. It just feels like a spa on your face. They have a rose one, which I haven't tried yet. Kelsey has that one and she loved that one, but this is the original. So I would, of course, repurchase this. Okay, so the next product I have here, it looks kind of disgusting. Like, how did it get like this? Okay, this is from the brand Raw Sugar and they have this brand at Target. This is a sugar scrub. This is the pineapple plus Maki berry plus coconut. This is an exfoliator and it says it repairs and replenishes, made from a natural sugarcane plant-based blend. This scrub is probably one of the closest scrubs that I can like compare to the Tree Hut scrubs. It's very abrasive. It is not a cute scrub. When I say cute, I mean very lackluster, doesn't really do much. It can exfoliate a baby's foot. I don't like them kind of scrubs. I don't need that. I need something that's heavy duty, that's gonna get the job done. And this product is amazing. So if you are ever in Target and you see this brand and you see their body scrubs, pick one up and thank me later because they're a bomb. They do have a more natural smell. They have a little bit of fragrance, like they smell nice, but they're not amazing smelling. But the actual scrub, like what it does for your skin is bomb. So it's very effective. And it's definitely up there with my Tree Hut scrub because all body scrubs are not created equal. Some of them are a complete waste of time, like this one. So this is from the brand This Works. It don't work. I got this from Amazon and this is called Perfect Legs 100% Natural Scrub. It says it's a buttery exfoliating balm with pink Himalayan salt and uplifting essential oils for a natural body glow. So this is probably good for someone with sensitive skin, someone who doesn't really like anything too abrasive, and I just realized why I don't like it. It's a salt scrub and I prefer sugar scrubs. So that is why. Salt scrubs have like, they're more fine in texture. They're not as abrasive. They are good if you have like body acne, which I don't, but this just didn't work for me. It didn't do much. It smells nice. It smells like a spa, like the natural earthy kind of smell, but like in a good way. It's really nice. The smell is the best part about this product, but if you prefer a sugar scrub, then don't get this. Okay, back to some hair products. This is from the brand Curls and this is their Poppin' Pineapple Collection. It's So So Def Vitamin C Curl Defining Jelly. This product is bomb. I love this jelly. I have tried quite a few of Curls gels. The last one I remember like being obsessed with was like the ones that she came out with back in the day. It was called Goddess Curls. And that's the last one I remember really loving. The other ones after that, I wasn't completely obsessed with. Like that one, I would always go back to the Goddess Curls. And this is what I would compare to it as far as how much I like that gel. This is really good. It has a very sweet smell though. If you're not into super sweet scents, then you will not like this. It kind of smells like, I don't know if you guys remember this product called Curly Meringue from Miss Jessie's. It's very similar to that smell. It smells like pineapple, but more like a souffle kind of sweet, like more of like a dessert kind of pineapple. It doesn't smell like just the fruit, it's more like a dessert. But it smells like summer. But if you don't like a sweet smell, then you wouldn't like the smell. But if you're into scents for your hair products, then you would love this. But the actual product, my hair was super defined, has great slip. I just wish the packaging was different because the product is on like the stickier, like thicker side. It feels like a jelly, like the name says. And the squeeze bottle does not make sense with the texture of this product. So I wish it was in a jar because I feel like I could get to the product a lot faster. Because when you're doing your hair, like us curly girls know, it gets messy. You get annoyed when you can't get the product out. And who want to be doing this forever? No one. I wish that it was in a like a tub, like a jar. So that's the only thing I do not like about this is the packaging. But the actual product inside is amazing. It is formulated with vitamin A, B1, B6, C for shiny, longer, thick, and healthy curls. It says it enhances hair growth, increases sebum, which is the scalp's natural oil, production, and decreases hair loss. I love this product. And if you guys have not tried anything from this collection, this is, you should get it. They do have a leave-in conditioner as well that I think I have in here. No, maybe not. I actually have another one of these gels. So I have two of these that I used up and I love this product. So I just wish the packaging was different because it got frustrating. Okay, so another body product. That's what's gonna be in this empty. So if y'all don't like hair products and body care, then you clicked the wrong video. This is a body lotion from Lush, and I love Lush. It's one of my favorite places to get like body products, and they of course have like a lot of natural ingredients, and it's just better for the environment because they recycle all of their containers. So this is the Sleepy Body Lotion. It says drift off into slumber with sweet lavender scented skin. Love this. It took me quite a while to use this because this is the really big container of the lotion. I usually get the smaller sizes just because I like to try out different ones. But this is really nice. It just smells like lavender dreams because lavender is not my most favorite scent. It has to be done right because sometimes lavender is a little bit like too strong for me. Like it doesn't really do much for me. But this is very calming and relaxing. And I think I like this one because it has vanilla in it. So it's like a nice balance. This actual formula though is bomb. It has cocoa butter in it, which if y'all know, I personally feel like cocoa butter works the best for black people or people with melanin in general. Everything that I've used with cocoa butter in it makes my skin like look amazing. So I think that's why I love this product as well. If you don't got cocoa butter in it, then it's probably not going to be the best moisturizer for me personally. This makes my skin super soft. It smells, it makes me want to go to sleep now. It's like a relaxing, really light scent. So I love this product and I will 1000% purchase it again. Next we have a Dove Go Fresh Rejuvenate Body Wash. You guys know Dove is one of my favorite brands of all time at the drugstore. Like I will buy it forever and ever. So this scent is the Pear and Aloe Vera scent. This one was really good. I typically like just the super like straight clean Dove scents, or I like some of their more spa smelling, like warmer, girlier scents. This is just really fruity. It's very summery to me, so I feel like I will only use this in the summertime. Again, yes, it smells like straight up summer, but if you're into like that apple, like crisp, like fresh smell, then you would love this. If you're not into fruity scents, then I don't know if you would like this, but if you love a good fruity apple or pear kind of scent, then this is bomb. This is so good. Y'all need this. Another one that I have here is the Summer Care one. This was limited edition. It's kind of bright, but this has like the yellow top. It's called Summer Care. So this one was a limited edition and it says it's softer, for softer, smoother skin after one shower. So this is a part of their Nutrient Moisture. Actually, all of them say Nutrient Moisture. Never mind. This one was really good as well. It's just based on the scent pretty much. If you like, this one's kind of citrusy too, but like a little bit warmer. And this one has little exfoliating beads in it. So this was bomb for summer. So I actually love this. If they come back out with this one, I will for sure get it this summer. And of course it's Dove, so it's always A1 as far as how it works on your skin. Okay, so another body wash brand that I actually love that I hardly ever talk about is Aveeno. This is the Positively Nourishing Purifying Body Wash. It has seaweed and oatmeal in it. It purifies and nourishes your skin. So this one I love. Like, out of most of their body washes, I always go back to this one. They have so many different ones, but this one is just like a sure thing for me. It smells very clean, very soft, very relaxing. Aveeno is one of my favorite brands, so I highly recommend this one if you guys aren't into like that super fruity, extra smelling like body wash smell. Aveeno is good if you're into like a more mellow, soft, spa, clean kind of area. You would love that. I feel like I have one of these in my bathroom already, so I don't have to repurchase at the moment, but when I do run out, I will for sure be getting this one. I feel like most of these products that I'm talking about, I've already said I would repurchase or I have backups of, because I just know what I like. That's very apparent. So the next product is a skincare product. This is from Shiseido. This is their Perfect Cleansing Oil. So I've been through quite a few of these, and this is the only cleansing oil so far that I've repurchased, because I have tried multiples in the past, but I haven't repurchased them. This is the only one that I've repurchased over and over. So this is really good for all skin types, but of course my skin type, because I have oily skin. But this is the product that I kept going back to over and over. It's amazing at removing your makeup. You can actually use a cleansing oil to cleanse your face even if you're not removing your makeup. So say you didn't wear makeup that day, you can still cleanse your face with a cleansing oil. Because I don't know if you guys have heard, but double cleansing is extremely important, and I've seen a huge difference in my skin when I started double cleansing. So I feel like the cleansing step is important, the most important to me, because none of your products will penetrate properly if you don't wash your face correctly. So that's why I'm so obsessed with like cleansing oils and balms and stuff. So this one is a sure thing. So if you are overwhelmed by all the cleansing oils out there, this one is really good. It's not super strong of a smell, like it's not too super super fragrant, and it's very consistent. So I love this product, and you guys should try it. I get mine at Sephora. Okay, so the next product is also a skincare product that took me forever to get through. This is the Health and Beauty Aztec Secret Indian Healing Clay. It says world's most powerful facial. I don't think that's true. I think professionals give you the best facials. But this is a really good at-home mask. I don't recommend doing this too often, because it can be kind of stripping to your skin. But if you are looking like to cleanse your pores, or like get all the gunk out of your skin, like maybe like once every other week, so maybe like once or twice a month, then you should definitely try this. I got mine at Whole Foods, and it lasts so long, because like the powder, it's a little powder. You can either mix it with water or apple cider vinegar. I do apple cider vinegar just because I feel like it's more effective like that. And when I tell you, your face literally looks like it's falling off, but it works. Like once it dries, it's like so, it's kind of scary at first, because like my eye was like down here on my cheekbone. It was very, very scary at first. But when you rinse it off, like you feel like you have a new face. It's really crazy, but it works. Oh, on the back it says, feel your face pulsate, which is very true. Next we have a body product, which is one of my favorite products actually. This is from the brand Caudalie, and this is their Divine Body Face and Hair Oil. I only use this on my body. I can't imagine really using this on my face, or anything that's meant for the body. I can't really imagine using it on my face, because I feel like it might be a little too heavy and it might clog my pores. But as a body oil, this is bomb. I just wish that they had like a bigger one. They may have a bigger one like on the Caudalie site, but this is very expensive for this 3.4 ounce glass bottle. I love the packaging. I just wish it was larger. And it kind of feels ridiculous paying that much for a body oil, but it feels so good on the skin. It's very light and like watery of an oil. It's not super thick or sticky. It's not like oils that steer some people away from oils, which I just said, that are thick and sticky. This one is very light, and it like dries really fast, but you still feel really nourished and moisturized. So I love this product. I love the smell of this. They also have a body scrub from this Divine line, and I love the scrub as well. But if you guys have not tried this oil, you need to and treat yourself. So whenever you get a chance to try this out, like during the sale or something, I highly recommend it. Obviously, I'm talking about the Sephora VIB sale. But this product is really good, and I try to use it sparingly just because I use a lot at once, just because I can't get enough, and I love the smell. So you can use this daytime, nighttime, whenever, but I go through it way too fast. Next we have a skincare product. This is from Thayer's. This is their Witch Hazel Aloe Vera Formula Alcohol Free Toner. I had the lavender one, and everybody and their mama has used Witch Hazel as a toner. I have been through quite a few Witch Hazel toners, and I will say if you do use any kind of Witch Hazel toners, this would be the best formula because it's alcohol free and this brand is very consistent. But I haven't heard the best things about Witch Hazel. I'm not a professional, but I have tried other toners that have worked better for me personally. So I'm just gonna stick with the toner that I use right now. But this is really good if you're looking for a drugstore option for a toner that's really gentle, that's not like too stripping for your skin. And if you have like acne prone skin, then I highly recommend some kind of Witch Hazel toner if you're looking for something affordable, because you can get many Witch Hazel options at the drugstore, but theirs to me is the best option. Everybody's skin is different, so I would not repurchase this just because I like the toner that I'm using currently. It's from Shani Darden, and I've been obsessed with that toner, so I won't go back to this one just because I love that one so much, but that's the only reason. Now, something I will be repurchasing that I already have repurchased, I think I repurchased like, I'm on my third one right now. This is the Pharmacy Honey Potion Renewing Antioxidant Hydration Mask. This is bomb. Y'all know I love this mask. This is my favorite hydrating mask. I've gone through so many of these. I've talked about over and over how beneficial honey is for the skin. It's very healing and it's so good for your skin. So Pharmacy is actually a really good brand. I think it's a clean and Sephora brand, and this is one of their best products in my opinion. I'm not a huge fan of face masks anymore like I used to be, because I realized that your skincare routine should do all the work, not face masks. Like, some people think they're miracle workers, but they're not. They are just supposed to maintain your skin, not, you know, transform them, if that makes sense. But this is a really good product. It's very hydrating. I love how it like heats up once you work it in with your fingers. It has like this warming, you know, type feature that I love. Next, I have one of my favorite body butters. This is the Lalabo body cream. Kelsey and I just mentioned this recently in our luxury products worth your coins or something like that. So like the bougie version of the cheap beauty products video, that are worth it video, the opposite of that. Y'all know we're wearing pink in the video if you want to check it out, that video. This product was in there, and I of course will be repurchasing, but I have so many body butters right now that I need to use. But this, there's nothing like this. It smells amazing. It smells like a spa, but a bougie rich spa. I feel like that's my reference. I'm horrible at describing scents because I always say it smells like a spa. It's fruity or sweet. I don't really know how else to describe it, but it has a very like warm, like bergamot. It kind of has like a cologne type scent to it, but with a hint of like mintiness in there. I'm trying. I'm really trying. If you have been eyeing products from this brand and wondering what to try, I told you to get the body cream and you're welcome. Next is another skincare product. This is CeraVe, from the brand CeraVe. This is their Renewing SA Cleanser for Normal Skin. So SA is Salicylic Acid Cleanser. So this is a non-comedogenic, non-drying, non-irritating cleanser with salicylic acid and ceramides. So if you do not try any skincare product in this video and you have been struggling with your skin and you don't know what else to try, keep your whole skincare routine really simple. Like, I mean, a moisturizer. If you just use this cleanser with a plain moisturizer, try it out and see if your skin looks any different in like a couple of months. You have to be consistent, because with any skincare routine, you have to be consistent to see any kind of results. But this product to me is CeraVe's best product. It's very effective. I feel like it cleared up my breakouts a lot faster, but it is on the drier side, even though it does have ceramides in it. And I think ceramides are like really good for like, they're really good for your skin. I just know that. But this is a really, really good product. I feel like a lot of drugstore brands are very gimmicky and they're all about like the advertising, and they don't really focus that much on the effectiveness of the products, because all they care about is like the look of everything, like the aesthetics. And I feel like they don't focus enough on the actual ingredients. But this product is very effective. And this does say developed with a dermatologist. It's not a dermatologist brand, but it's developed with them. On the back it says it detoxifies and exfoliates to remove dirt and oil, salicylic acid, softens and smooths skin. It's basically an exfoliant. If you guys don't know, salicylic acid is a chemical exfoliant and it does wonders for your skin. Three essential ceramides help repair the skin barrier. See, I knew ceramides were good in some way for the skin. Enriched with antioxidant vitamin D, gentle and non-drying. It was a little drying for my skin, unless I was just cleansing my face too much with this, because I was using this in the morning and at night. It's non-comedogenic and non-irritating, and it's fragrance-free, so it does not have a smell. I love this product. So if you are looking for a good drugstore product that's effective, try this out and then just get maybe a the CeraVe moisturizer, like their oil-free moisturizer. Try that routine out. If you're looking for something simple and you're on a budget, I recommend this cleanser. Next, we have something that I would not recommend. This is the La Mer Moisturizing Soft Cream. This is a complete waste of time and money and glass. It smells nice, luxurious. The brand is very well known around the globe for how bougie and expensive it is. And I feel like most people use it just for the name. They don't know if it's actually working for them. So for me personally, I would not repurchase this product or anything from this brand just because I feel like it's not very effective on my skin. I can only speak for myself, not for others. So for me, it did not do anything. Again, I have very oily skin and this wasn't good for my face at all. So if you guys are wondering about this brand, not for me. Next, we have a perfume, which it takes me a minute to go through perfume, surprisingly, because I use so much. But this is from Versace. This is their Dylan Blue perfume. And I love this perfume, like the smell, but it does not last long on me. So that's the only reason why I would not repurchase it, because I have had this size and I had like a mini one that I kept in my purse. And I had to constantly keep spraying myself with it. And I'm someone who likes a heavier, not as far as smell, but the formula of a perfume. I just like it to like last and stick to my skin all day. And if I feel like reapplying a perfume that complements the one I wore earlier that day, so say I wear like something sweet that day, I have like another sweet like mini size in my purse. This is clean, but it has a hint of like warmth in there. It's actually really good. I'm a fan of the smell, but I wish it lasted longer on me. So if this lasts long on you, then lucky you, because it smells really good, but I wouldn't repurchase because I have other scents that last longer on me. But Dylan Blue from Versace, it's bomb. Next, we have another skincare product. This is from Tata Harper, and this is their resurfacing mask for an instant glow. So I actually love her face mask. I used to use like her whole line, like that was like my whole skincare routine, but I feel like it wasn't doing enough for my skin because I feel like I needed more active ingredients in my skincare routine. And you guys know Tata Harper's known for like all her natural ingredients and doing things the natural way. And I feel like some natural ingredients are good and some natural products are good, but not your whole routine. Like, I just don't know if I subscribe to that message when it comes to skincare, because everybody's skin is so different that not like all natural, I feel like it's not gonna be as effective as certain other active ingredients. That's just my opinion, that's my experience. So yeah, but this product is one of my favorites of hers. This is basically an exfoliating face mask, but it gently exfoliates. I love the smell of her products. Like, her whole like line is very relaxing to me. It's something really soothing about the smell of her products. But this product in particular is really good. Again, I said I don't depend on face masks to do all the work for me, but when I feel like my skin needs like a little something extra, I do like to use a face mask, and this is one of them. It's very tiny, so it's really good to travel with. And I like this one and her other one, which is the green one. It's like the clay mask. It's green. So I love that one as well as like the clearing mask or something like that. It's probably not the right name. But this one is really good. If you guys have not tried any of her products, I say start with the face mask and see if you like those. This is really, really good though. It gives your skin a really nice glow because it says resurfacing. So it's basically getting all the dead skin off your face. And like, you just see like a nice glow, like once you rinse it off, it's really nice actually. So I love this product. I will definitely repurchase, but it's kind of on the pricier side for the amount of product that you get. So I don't know about that. And last but not least, I have a shower gel that I got from TJ Maxx from Bliss. This is their Fabulous Foaming Body Wash. This is a 2-in-1 cleanser and exfoliator. This was a really good cleanser, but I find that it didn't do much in the exfoliating department, so they should not have put exfoliator on here because the beads were literally like decoration. They didn't serve an actual purpose in the shower, but it smells really good. It kind of smells like a summer, like smells like very oceany, like a aqua kind of smell. Smells like a sea breeze kind of smell, kind of like air freshener, but in a good way. So if you guys see any of the Bliss shower gels, try them and let me know how you like them, because I did enjoy this, but not as an exfoliator. This says it does have lactic and citric acids in it to smooth the skin. But if there's lactic acid in this, I don't see why you would need the beads, because I think lactic acid is a chemical exfoliant and not a physical exfoliant. So I don't know. It says it has glycerin, vitamin E, and jojoba in it. So it was hydrating. I did enjoy that part of this. So if you see this anywhere, pick it up. I don't even know if they still have it. Maybe it's discontinued at this point. But when I saw it in TJ Maxx, I bought two, and this was the second one that I finished. So apparently I enjoyed it, but I have so many shower gels and body washes that I'm not wowed by one in particular. I don't really discriminate. Okay, you guys, so that wraps up this Empties video of mine. Let me know if you would still like me to do these like every few months, like once I've collected a good amount of products, a nice variety. Even though most of this video were hair care and body care products, but I typically enjoy buying those products. But let me know if you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you would like Kelsey and I to keep doing these separate or together. I actually don't mind doing this one, these separately, because all of our other videos for the most part are together. So just let me know what you guys, you know, want to see. Comment down below if you have repurchased any of these products, and let me know if you're going to purchase any of the ones that I recommended, because I personally think I have, you know, pretty good opinion when it comes to products, because I've tried so many and I don't sugarcoat when it comes to what works and what does not work. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.